The People's Court today at 4:30.
Raymond, this is crazy. We shouldn't.
What were you talking about up there, that you had to go away on business? Was that true?
Yeah, it's true.
How can you do that to me just when I'm in the middle of all this trouble? It's not fair.
Do you think it's fair for me to be here to watch the woman that I love marry another man?
Oh, baby, this is horrible. I don't know if I can do this.
All right. If it's too much for you, if you feel you can't handle it, then just don't. That's all. Don't.
Then what's going to happen to you if I tell them I don't want to be their spy?
They'll throw me to the wolves, I guess. Send over their federal agents to my house in 10 minutes.
All right, look. Maybe Ian will tell me everything right away. He did promise to tell me everything on our wedding night, so maybe right after the wedding I can get all the answers.
Yeah, the only answer that we need is where that list of spies, that phone book is. Once we get that, we'll have all of them off our backs.
Yeah, but then I'll be married to him, not you.
Just for a little while, baby, because then he's going to go to jail and you are going to marry me.
All right, so what happens in the meantime?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean. Valerie Bryson.
Do you think I could fall for her after I've loved you? I mean, I couldn't come to the party alone. Ian is still suspicious of you and me, and we've got to keep that in mind. I just brought Valerie along because I wanted him to think that my affections are elsewhere.
Just don't get carried away, okay?
Sounds like an intercom.
Why would they call here?
I don't know. Let me find out.
Maybe you shouldn't answer.
Hello?
Skyler, it's Geraldine.
Well, hello, Geraldine.
Just tell me one thing. Is Raven there with you now?
Now, why in the world would you ask that?
Please answer me. Tell me the truth. Because Ian Devereaux is on his way to the train room right now.
Edge of Night is brought to you by Pampers. America's mothers trust their babies to Pampers dryness. And by April Fresh Downy, America's favorite fabric softener.
Honey, you'll get chilly. Here.
Well, you washed it. I was going to do that. We share the housework.
Then how come I do the laundry?
Well, hey, where's the softness this usually has?
Oh?
He noticed. You didn't use Downy. There's a big difference without the softener.
And where's that nice fresh smell?
It ought to smell fresh now. I just washed it.
You know only Downy makes your clothes smell April fresh.
Only Downy combines April freshness with skin-loving softness. Helps rinse out static cling.
Honey, this shirt feels soft again. And smells fresh.
He sure notices the difference.
You don't need me to do the laundry.
Not when it's your turn to cook.
April fresh Downy. A noticeable improvement.
I'm budget manager of the Randall family. My job's to keep expenses down. Mr. Open Refrigerator here doesn't help. It's a tough job, because I want what's right for my family. That means cushion quilted Pampers. I've tried bargain brands once. Pampers help keep my Kathy a lot drier, and dryness is what I want for my baby.
Look, wait a Pampers and the average bargain brand. Wait a minute. Slip in a blotter. Pampers cushion quilted lining helps keep babies a lot drier.
Did I use Pampers too, Mom?
Mm-hmm. Pampers help keep babies a lot drier. Give me Kathy's bottle and...
I know. Close your refrigerator door.
Cushion quilted Pampers helps keep a little baby a lot drier.
Now, there's no reason for you not to take the coat. I mean, after all, it used to be your coat, even though it was bought with my money by Jeff Brown.
No, thank you.
You wouldn't let me keep anything when I was at the house. Not my furs, not my jewelry, not my dresses, not nothing. So I don't want anything now. I don't care if it is a wedding present.
David Ray wanted to understand I'm not doing this for you. I am doing it for my old friend Ian. I'm simply trying to...
Well, well, well. What's all the racket about?
Hello.
Oh, Ian, I'm so glad you're here. Will you please tell your friend that I don't want any favors?
What kind of favor did you have in mind, Scott?
I made the mistake of thinking your fiancé had some degree of understanding. I was wrong.
Understanding about what?
Your pal over here is trying to give me a fur coat, which is mine in the first place. For someone who has so much money, you sure are cheap.
I was simply trying to make a nice gesture, Raven, since there's so much ill feeling between you and I, and you are about to marry my best friend. Well, all right, I was wrong.
All right, you two, that is enough. This is an engagement party. I don't want to see my friends arguing with each other.
Well, this argument began quite some time ago when I came back to Monticello and I found her living in my house and spending my money.
All those things were given to me and I didn't know they were stolen. Besides, I didn't steal them. Jefferson Brown did.
She does have a point, Skye.
Oh, yes, and a very good point, too. I'm sure that if she had known the money was stolen, she would have given it back instantly.
I would have. Except you completely came in and stripped me first.
Well, I am attempting now to give it back to you. And don't think that this is your wedding present. It isn't. You'll get your usual set of ugly matched china or a silver plate with...
All right, you two, that is enough. I can't have my future wife and my best friend spending the night arguing with each other.
Well, thank you very much. At least you understand something, Ian.
It was a wonderful gesture you made, and I appreciate it. But I don't really think she'll be needing the coat. You see, we're going to be returning to the Caribbean.
You like it so much, you're going back for more, huh?
Yes. And this time we'll be man and wife. And we may not ever come back.
I knew from the very beginning that I was being blackmailed, but I didn't care because for $25,000, she said that she would name the name of the person who actually beat up Barbara and provide proof of their guilt, and that would clear Miles' name. So, I thought that if I could get her statement on videotape, that it would be far more conclusive than either a written or an oral statement. So she agreed to it, and we decided to meet at WMON after hours on that evening. And I thought that that would resolve the problem once and for all.
Just Nicole, excuse me, Derek. Nicole, the idea of revenge, the idea of killing Nora, never entered your head before you went to the studio, right?
No. I just wanted to get her statement on tape and pay her and then be rid of her.
All right, so you went to the TV studio at the appointed time, right?
Yes, I did, and Nora was already there. She was waiting for me.
Wait a minute. TV studio was locked after hours. How did Nora get in there?
Well, she must have had a key from when she worked for me before.
Well, but there was no key found on her body.
Well, I don't know what happened to it.
All right.
So, I started the tape and she sat in front of the camera and she started talking and then all of a sudden this sort of wild, crazy look came into her eyes. I should have known what was going to happen, but she began to describe with this malicious pleasure the fact that she had absolutely no intention of helping Miles. And suddenly, I hated her. I've never hated anything more in my life, and I don't know what happened. It's just sort of this rage overcame me, and I just looked for something. I looked for anything I could find, and I found this black cable, and I didn't mean to. I was just overcome by this, I don't know, it was like this force that was greater than my own conscience, and I simply killed her. That's what happened.
Yes?
Can I come in?
Uh-huh.
I just wanted to see how you were feeling.
Oh,
I feel numb. Is Miles home yet?
No, he's still at the hospital. He's just visiting some former patients.
Well, I know how he feels about his patients, but I guess I'm just selfish enough to wish he would come home.
Well, I don't think that's selfish. But maybe what I should do is call the hospital, tell him his most important patient.
No, please, Jody. I don't want him to feel like he has to start treating me like a patient.
Okay. I didn't mean it that way.
But I guess we should get used to being apart.
Now, that's enough of that. You're not going to be separated at all. Look, weren't you the one that thought you'd be in prison right now because they weren't going to set bail? Yet here you are.
Yeah, here I am.
And you're not going to prison either. I can practically guarantee that.
How?
Because Cliff and Dee Dee are working very hard on this case. And they're both sure that they can get you off on a temporary insanity plea. Now, if the court agrees to that, you don't go to jail, Nicole. You go home.
Or you go to an insane asylum.
Hello? Oh, hi, Dee Dee.
Listen, Jody, I had an idea, or rather, Cliff had an idea. I kind of thought you would want to stay home tonight and be with your sister.
Yeah, you were right. Miles isn't here, and... No, I don't think I should go out.
Jody, please go. I told you, all I want to do is just lie here and sleep.
No, look, Nicole, it's all right. I really don't feel like it anyway.
Well, anyway, I just thought I would tell you that Calvin and Damien, Poppy and I are going to that new place that opened up, the video disco. And then afterwards, we're going to come back to the Rock Garden and have coffee and dessert.
Well, Dee Dee, I appreciate the invitation, but I think I'm going to pass.
I understand. Well, I just wanted you to know that we were thinking of you.
Listen, I'll tell you what. Maybe if Miles gets home, I'll stop by at the Rock Garden. You can tell me all about the video disco. All right, have a good time. Bye-bye.
Jody, please, I want you to go. I don't want you changing your life. I don't want anyone changing their life because of me. Will you just please go?
Well, I can tell by the look on your face the answer must be no.
You're right. Well, you can't really blame her, I guess.
Come on, ladies, let's go. And prepare yourself for a nervous breakdown, because that's what this place is like.
I'm really curious to see it.
Yeah, I'm curious about something there myself. Any answers to the name of the preacher?
Looking for the perfect nail polish?
Isn't everybody?
Introducing new Q-Tex Perfect Color. As close to perfect as polish can get. Q-Tex Perfect Color is made with high stamina sealers, so days later it won't fade, frazzle, or dim its dazzle. Q-Tex, perfect color for nails in 46 great colors.
Perfect.
This may look like kid stuff to all you laymen, but I assure you it took years and years of experience to develop this skill.
And long years of training, too, huh?
Excuse me.
Oh, hello, Geraldine. You're just in time to catch the next train.
Yes, well, I just thought I'd come in to see that everything is all right in here.
Well, everything was just fine until these two lousy train jokes, but anyway, why are you asking?
Well, simply because both of you seem to have vanished during your own engagement party, and that seemed just a little peculiar.
Yes, as proper hosts, we should return to our guests.
No, I didn't mean that. I'm sure everyone is having a perfectly fine time.
Well, in that case, Geraldine, perhaps you can settle a minor quarrel.
All right. I'll take the coat.
Good. I'll have it delivered to your hotel tomorrow.
Well, I am going to be running some errands tomorrow, so maybe I could just come and pick it up.
Well, I'm not sure that anybody will be home. Spencer is going to be out all day, and Gunther will be taking me to the airport.
You're going on the business trip tomorrow?
Yes, I have got a lot of preparation before my meeting, so sooner the better.
How long will you be gone, Skyler?
A week, I suppose, perhaps more.
Oh, dear, then you'll miss the wedding.
Yeah, I know, that's a damn shame, but there's nothing I can do about it. That's why I wanted to get this wedding gift business over with.
Oh, that is a pity, old boy. We're both gonna miss you.
Yeah. Well, I better go check in with Valerie. She must think I deserted her. Excuse me.
Maybe I should, too. Are you coming, Ruth?
Yeah, I'll be there in a second. I want to have a word with Geraldine.
All right.
So, Skylar, are you going on this trip alone?
Yes. Spencer won't be coming.
And you're not taking Miss Bryson?
No. No, I'll be going by myself.
So, what was that all about?
You mean warning you about Ian Devereux?
Yes, what made you think I need a warning?
Intuition. Something rather strange going on among you three. And I haven't quite figured it out as yet.
Well, thank you, but it really wasn't necessary. But thanks.
Pert shampoo. It'll help bring back the bounce.
Sassy bounce.
A classy bounce.
A happy bounce.
And a snappy bounce.
Pert shampoo. It'll bring back the bounce.
Pert shampoo. Pearly green smells terrific with a whisper of conditioning. Pert will help bring back the bounce.
There's a party bounce.
A smarty bounce.
A shorty bounce.
And a sporty bounce.
Pert shampoo. It'll bring back.
There's some good country singers in my family, and some great Crisco cooks. And when we get together, we share our best Crisco cooking.
Aunt Loretta, you've got to tell me how you made these turnovers.
Well, I start with a Crisco crust. I mix up my apples, cranberries, and cinnamon. I scoop it in the crust and bake. Then I put on the icing.
The crust is so flaky.
That's Crisco.
Look for Loretta's family recipes in your favorite women's magazines.
Crisco do you proud every time.
Great cake, hon. I had to have seconds.
You had thirds, but who's counting?
Here's another dish.
The dishes are done, and so are the pans. But Dawn can handle that.
You're going to wash this after greasy pans?
No, you are, with Dawn.
Hey, nothing feels greasy. The water, my hands, nothing. And my plate looks as good as the first.
No kidding.
Dawn did some job on the chocolate cake.
So did you.
Dawn takes grease out of your way.
Dr. Cavanaugh, are you through with the Montgomery file?
Yes, Doc.
I need it for radiology.
Thank you.
Miles.
Jody, what are you doing here?
Oh, I just thought I'd come down and see how busy you are.
You checking up on me?
No, as a matter of fact, well, to tell you the truth, I called you on the page, but you didn't answer, so I thought I'd come down here and see if I could find you.
Isn't Nicole? Something wrong with Nicole?
No, Miles, she's not sick, but she's very depressed.
Yeah, I know. Look, I wanted to get out of here an hour ago, and I was going to, except an old patient of mine had to go for emergency surgery. I was down in the OR when he called.
I see.
Jody, I want to be with her, but it's real hard, you know, trying to do a job you're supposed to be doing and deal with what she's going through at the same time.
Well, I didn't mean to make you feel guilty.
No, it's all right. Look, the trial won't be for a while, you know, and it's important that we keep on living our lives until that happens. If we've got jobs to do, we have to not neglect them. Otherwise, it's just going to make her feel worse.
You're right. You're right. In fact, she said the same thing herself.
Tell you what, I'll go home with you right now after just seeing one more patient. Whenever I'm here, I always promise myself to see Barbara.
Has there been any change since the last one?
Why don't we find out? You want to come in with me?
Can I?
Yeah.
Oh, hello, Dr. Cavanaugh.
Hello, doctor.
How's the patient, Miss Niven?
Not much change. Although she does speak more often. Just a few minutes ago, she said something.
Really? What was it?
Nobody's really sure. Just one word. And now she keeps saying it over and over.
Well, maybe this word means something to her.
Maybe it does. Barbara?
Miles, I think she's trying to say something.
Barbara, it's Dr. Cavanaugh. What are you trying to say to us?
Rachel. It sounds like creature.
I think this makes everything better.
Well, what'd I tell you, Nate?
Oh. Nervous breakdown with a very good description.
Hey, it's gonna go crazy. Let's have a
that straight up or on the rocks?
Rocks.
Okay.
You enjoy being the bartender here?
I'm not the regular bartender. See, I run this whole video system. I run the whole show.
Oh, very impressive. Very good.
You know, I take the place of the regular bartender sometimes. Now that you know what I do, what do you do?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm a lawyer.
A lawyer, huh?
As a matter of fact, I'm working on a very big case right now. You know about the Nora Fulton case?
Never heard of it.
Now that's funny, because some people that I know seem to think that you knew Nora Fulton.
What people? Oh, I get it. Your friends are the cops, right?
Look, I'm not accusing you of anything. The murderer has already confessed. So it really couldn't hurt you to tell me everything that you knew.
Why don't you do me a favor? Why don't you and the rest of your circus clowns quit bugging me? Okay, you remind me of a bunch of little ants. You know what I do to ants? I step on them. And as far as what you heard about me, well, it's all wrong. I didn't know those chicks, you understand? I didn't know them at all. Fritz! Fritz! Take over!
Well, you managed to get anything out of him?
No, nothing much.
Well, I told you the man wasn't going to be exactly cooperative.
You were right.
This is the man.
He said something awfully funny when I asked him about Nora Fulton. He said he didn't know anything about those chicks. Now, what do you think he meant about that?
Those chicks.
Comtrex relieves the whole cold.
Dristan didn't relieve my cough.
But Comtrex relieves the whole cold.
Contact didn't do anything for my aches, pains, and fever.
But Comtrex relieves the whole cold.
Bear didn't help my nasal congestion, runny nose, or coughing.
But Comtrex relieves the whole cold. That means Comtrex works on nasal and sinus congestion, runny nose, sneezing, coughing, watery eyes, sore throat, nasal drip, headache, fever, pain, every major cold symptom. Comtrex, it relieves the whole cold.
Are you a saltaholic? Sure you are, because salt hides in most everything, even where you don't expect it. Most Americans get 20 times the salt their bodies need, so why salt the salt? No salt flavors like salt without salt. Cook with no salt. Shake with no salt. Since there's salt in most everything, who needs more salt? No salt. And shake the salt habit. Soon in restaurants, ask for it.
On One Life to Live, the wedding begins.
You take Delilah to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have, to hold.
Until Bo arrives.
And you forget the part about anybody having any objections?
One Life to Live.
Weekdays.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh,
a little emergency with one of my old patients.
No, don't apologize. There are no apologies necessary.
Well, yes, sir. Because that's not the whole story.
Why, what do you mean?
Well, I wasn't just at the hospital. Before that, I made a little appearance before the medical review board.
Well, Miles, why didn't you tell me that?
Oh, I didn't think you ought to have something else to worry about.
Oh.
At any rate, I made the appearance at the request of Mr. Everett Cooper, who, by the way, is out of the hospital. He's back home. He's back in harness as
well,
chairman.
What happened?
I just told him the truth as honestly as I could and in as much detail as I could. But admittedly, that wasn't much.
Well, what happened? Did they accept his recommendation for reinstatement?
This old geezer there, this Dr. Morrison, who kept saying that maybe Mr. Cooper's recommendation was just out of gratitude. He was grateful.
Well, he should be. He saved his life.
Yeah, well, that isn't sufficient grounds for reinstatement.
Oh, come on, Miles, all right, please.
All right, I'll get to the punchline. I guess I ought to tell you. Yes, the answer is yes, but reinstated.
Oh, I'm so happy.
As a condition, though.
Why, what's that?
Well, if anything develops, in the case of Barbara Montgomery, if I am indicted for assault, I stand to lose my license permanently.
It won't happen. It won't happen, I'm sure of it. I just can't be that unfair.
This is a great place.
Yeah, let's go back.
Yeah. Hey, look who's here.
Well, you beat us here, huh?
Yeah, I left the house just as soon as Miles would be with me for.
How's she doing, Jody?
She's fine.
So how is this disco? You guys didn't stay very long.
Nobody could stay there very long if you value your vision or your hearing.
Well, let's just say it's interesting enough for you and Gavin to try some night or other.
Yes, it's definitely for the young people, right, Damien?
Oh, that's right, Grandma.
Well, I don't know if I'm up to that right now. Maybe after this Norfolk thing's over.
You know, Jody, there was somebody at this video disco who knew Nora Fulton. The problem is, nobody could get him to talk about her.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, when Dee Dee asked him about Nora, he said, I never knew those chicks. Now, why would he use the plural?
Well, who was this guy anyway?
His name is Preacher. He's the guy that runs all the video effects.
What's his name?
Preacher. And take it from me, it's definitely a nickname.
Another bowl of cereal.
It just isn't breakfast.
Another cup of coffee.
It just isn't breakfast.
A chocolate-covered donut.
It just isn't breakfast.
Without eggs.
Fried eggs, home steak, scrambled eggs, too. Soft-boiled sandwich, eggs will do. It just isn't breakfast.
Without eggs.
The incredible edible egg.
When you need a little lift, but you just can't take a break, chew Wrigley's Spearmint Gum.
The cool, refreshing feeling of Wrigley's Spearmint Gum puts a little lift in everything you do. That good, smooth chewing, that crisp, clean taste, that Wrigley's Spearmint pickup is going for you.
Wrigley's Spearmint Gum really keeps you humming. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum keeps you humming along. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum really keeps you humming. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum keeps you humming.
Television event that will captivate millions premieres Sunday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain. Herman Wokes, The Winds of War.
This is David Hartman for Early News. It's World News This Morning. Monday on Good Morning America, all the latest news, plus Carl Malden. Our week-long movie reunions begin with Shirley Temple and Buddy Ebsen of Captain January. Tuesday, Gone with the Wind on Good Morning America.
Tonight on ABC's World News Tonight, unemployed Americans are running out of benefits and hope.
You wonder how you'll pay your rent, your mortgage, how your kids want to eat.
Max Robinson reports on the plight of millions as the money runs out. ABC News, uniquely qualified to bring you the world.
42nd Street, Broadway's all-time musical hit. Some seats available tonight. Call Telecharge 246-0730.
I'm Roseanne Scamardella. Coming up on the 5 o'clock Eyewitness News, both subway and street traffic are a mess right now in Long Island City, Queens. That's because an elevated subway train derailed. No passengers on that train. We'll have live coverage and this.
Lady of Bricktown, New Jersey has been ordered to abandon her flock. I'm John Buchan. I'll have the details.
Also, singer Karen Carpenter is dead at the age of 32. We'll have a full report and more at 5 o'clock.
Years ago, great home cooking began with the arrival of the Progresso truck.
Tony! Send
it carried the Progresso foods that became legendary for homemade goodness. Today, you can enjoy that homemade flavor with Progresso Italian-style burgers.
At Wilfred Academy.
Wilfred Academy can prepare you for a career in the fast-growing beauty field. Financial aid is available now if you qualify.
Step up to a beautiful future at Wilfred Academy.
Call Wilfred Academy right now.
Step up.